Revelio.
Either I'll have to fight that troll, or... Felt that in London.
Revelio. Lumos. Revelio. Lumos. Revelio.
The pulse.
Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
This must be Sirona's box of letters. I should take this box of letters to Sirona. She'll be glad to have it back. I think that's everything. Sirona will be glad to have this back.
What? If it isn't Nora Kimbrough.
Hang on!
You
have
in the
knack
at all!
What?
Kimbrough!
Your eyes. quick flick of a frock and you fall to pieces.
The Ministry ought to loosen the reins on the Dark Arts. No better protection, if you ask me. Someone's going to regret trespassing. I'm out! You've made a mistake!
Get my claws out.
Reducto!
Never like vegetables! You! Some annoying little weed. Little pruning. Admirable trick. Annoying little weed.
You can't take one of my own.
You will fall. Don't
let him hurt you, teacher. You're a big dodgy with your skills, aren't you, sweetheart?
Reducto.
Oh, what's the last one?
I bet that one hurt.
Reducto! Reducto! Oh, this is getting fun!
Confringo! Defender!
Reducto!
My bite is worse than my bite.
Depulsor!
Confringo!
Defendo!
Places!
Confringo! Defendo! Depulsor!
It's shameful what you've done to helpless beasts. Revelio.
Confringo!
Revelio!
Depulsor!
Lumos! Revelio!
Lumos!
Revelio. 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 Lumos. Revelio. Lumos. Revelio.
Right out of a storybook.
Shane Bardolph thought so.
Hogsmeade, here I come. Hello, Sirona. I have good news. I was able to provide your friend Mrs. Sprottle with some hawk lumps for her Wiggermel potion, and I found your box of letters.
Oh, thank you. I knew you were the one to ask.
I wondered about some of the letters in the box.
Of course. It appears most of the letters were from fellow students.
One of the letters mentions Quidditch practice. Did you play?
I did. Was the Ravenclaw Seeker for 3 years. Oh, Merlin's beard. I adore Quidditch. Nothing like the feeling of catching the golden snitch when your team's down by 140 points. I'll never forgive Professor Black for cancelling it this year. I missed cheering for Ravenclaw. We could have cheered them on together.
I saw a letter from someone named Mirabelle. Is that Professor Garlick?
It is. Still one of my dearest friends. I know she wouldn't mind you having seen that letter. she and I are of a similar mind, especially when it comes to young people. We believe experience to be an invaluable teacher. To borrow a phrase from Mirabelle, it's a joy to see anyone blossom, but particularly one who doubted they ever would.
I spotted a letter from you to Mrs. Sprottle. You two seem to have a lot of fun together.
We do. She taught me so much during my summers with her and Aiden. I shall be the first to admit that adolescents aren't always the easiest to understand. And not everyone was as kind to me as the Sprottles. But the depth of their kindness, and that of so many of my friends, got me through... well, got me through some challenging times, to put it mildly.
I'm glad I could be of help. Mrs. Sprottle sends her best.
Don't know what I'd have done without her and Aiden. Thank you, again, for helping her. And for returning this box of letters. It's nice to reflect on good memories.
What are you up to now?
Seems a pleasant enough little place.
Bardolph Beaumont should have returned by now. Had by dark wizards he was.
Excuse me, did you say something about Bardolph Beaumont?
Oh, hello again. How nice to see you. And yes, I did. I was just worrying about Claire Beaumont's brother, Bardolph. Only he's gone missing. Rumour is he was seen in the forest practising dark magic. Saw him myself near some ruins with Rookwood's lot I did. I fear he got himself into trouble with the Ashwinders, especially if he made them a promise he couldn't keep. I'd help search for him myself, but no one will risk encountering Ranrock's loyalists. They seem to be everywhere.
Why would Bardolph want to get involved with the Ashwinders?
Oh, he had a terrible run-in with Ranrock's loyalists. Changed him. He vowed never to feel powerless again. I think he sought the Ashwinders out to learn their secrets. Victor Rookwood, at least, seems somehow immune to Ranrock's loyalists.
Do you think Bardolph may have simply run off?
No. Bardolph's run that shop with Claire his entire life. He'd not give it up for anything. He swore he'd be back in a fortnight. My instincts are that he's been held captive, or worse.
I can certainly look out for him.
Any help would be appreciated. You might speak to Claire first. Perhaps she has some insights that I don't. I can tell you that Bardolph was last seen in the forest wearing a particular woolen jumper, one that Claire knitted herself. Claire will be at her shop if you'd like to speak with her.
Madame Beaumont, might I speak with you?
Yes. What about?
Mrs. Sprottle told me a little about your brother's disappearance.
Oh, dear Dorothy. She'd go looking for Bardolph herself if she could.
She mentioned dark magic and even the Ashwinders.
Despite my repeated warnings, Bardolph's been experimenting with dark magic near the edge of the forest. I thought perhaps he'd get it out of his system and it would gradually stop. But then one day, he didn't come home.
Could Bardolph have run off?
No. He'd never leave me here alone. He did speak of going to talk with Victor Rookwood. That worries me almost more than his attempts at mastering dark magic. Rookwood is as dangerous as Ranrok, in my opinion.
Is there anything your brother took with him that might help to track him down?
Only his satchel, journal, and a woolen jumper I knitted for him. That's all I can recall.
I'll let you know if I see or hear anything about him.
Thank you. How kind. I'd be so grateful to learn where he is. I know in my heart he's out there. Do be careful.
What do you have for sale?
Bardolph, where are you? I'll not give up hope. Marvellous. I could always use more of these. Ranrok's loyalists are not to be underestimated. Thank you for passing through.
You instruments are expensive. I remember you.
It seems as though things are getting worse. Best be on my guard.
Such arrogance.
Blood's on Ranrok's hands.
One camp down, one more to go.
Revelio.
Enjoy suffering, do you?
Mushroom stew.
One less human to worry about.
I was right not to be worried about you.
Glacius. Confringo.
No!
Repulsor. Defender. Glacius.
I won't rest.
Confringo.
Both camps cleared. Madame Beaumont will be glad to hear that.
Revelio.
I've always said that travel broadens the mind.
Wonder who lives here.
I do miss the bustle of business. Poor...
Hello, Madame Beaumont. Good news. I was able to clear out Ranrock's camps.
You cleared them out? How?
I managed to catch them off guard.
When my brother returns, this news will mean the world to him. You saved our hamlet, my young friend. This will not be forgotten. I fear for other hamlets, truly. Ranrock and his lot are unlike any goblins I've ever seen.
I should be going now. Thank you.
Thank you. Sincerely.
Madame Beaumont, any news regarding your brother Bardolf?
I'm afraid not. He was last seen in his wool jumper, practicing curses with Ashwinders near the forest.
What do you have for sale?
What are you looking for exactly? Thank you for passing through.
The river near the forest. I must be on the right track.
Revelio.
Confringo. Glacier.
Is that M2 wearing a wooden jacket? That must be really happened to him.
Revelio.
Entry from Bardolph's journal. He overheard whispers, a plan, something to do with him.
Revelio.
This mentions in theory. And something about it being Bardolph's turn next.
In the clouds of dark is always the best time to strike. It's as if nature herself has failed.
Revelio.
This looks intriguing.
On another adventure, are we?
Not sure how I'd fare in a little place like this.
Oh, I do hope my brother is all right.
Madame Beaumont, I do have some news of your brother.
Oh, please tell me he's safe.
I regret to say that Bardolph had been turned into an Inferius, and I had to kill him.
What? But how could you possibly think that an Inferius was my brother Bardolph? That's absurd.
He was wearing a woolen jumper, hand-knitted.
No. No. This can't be.
I'm truly sorry. I wish it had been better news. I wish you well, Madame Beaumont.
What more could I have done? Oh, Bardolph! Bardolph! My dear, dear brother!
What are you looking for exactly?
Thank you for passing through.
Oh,
it's you.